very much for coming today to celebrate the reopening of the A379. It's kind of a milestone for us, obviously, getting to this point. So it's beautiful that the weather is actually so much better than it was in the beginning of March when sadly we lost the road. I just want to say this before handing over to Sarah Wollaston, that this is part of the work that we're doing. As some of you who have come through Tool Cross will know, we're still working on the works down there. And there'll be ongoing environmental mitigation works for a while yet to come. That's enough from me. I'm going to hand over now to Sarah Wollaston to say a few words.
Thank you so much. And thank you to all of you coming today, because I think we all deserve to be really proud of what's been achieved here. And this, I look at this road and I see amazing teamwork right from the very start. That was a result of the Slapton Line Partnership. So everybody here from the Slapton Line Partnership, can I ask you to give them a huge round of applause, because it really was remarkable what they've achieved. And none of this happened by accident. At any stage, things could have gone wrong. But to think that half a kilometre of this road was washed away in storm Emma in those terrible conditions, and now look at it today. We know we're on borrowed time. We know this isn't the end of the story. And we have to start now looking to what happens in the future. But for today, this is a time for celebration and thank yous. And also, I'd just like to say a special thanks as well to Peter Chamberlain. Because I think without the work that he did so quickly, I don't think any of this would have been possible. So thank you very much. And of course, thank you to all those who moved every single slow worm and that I've been hearing about, and did the really detailed environmental work on the ground, because we know that this isn't just about a road, this is about a really special, fragile environment. So thank you to all of you. That's lovely for me. We'll pass over. It's lovely not to be talking about Brexit.
Can I now invite Roger English to come up and say a few words on behalf of Slapton Line Partnership?
Yes, welcome, and thank you for the opportunity to speak on behalf of the partnership. The Start Bay area, and Slapton Line in particular, is obviously no stranger at all to coastal storms. If we look back over recent history, then perhaps we remember the storms back in 2001, further ago into the 70s, and then we get into that kind of hazy territory, really, where records, historical records, tell us what's happened in the area, but we perhaps haven't got that fresh in our minds. We go back further afield still and look at geological time. Clearly the area has changed in response to coastal pressures, coastal storms, in a very large way, and the way in which the shingle barrier has moved around over that period of time is really incredible to see when you look at it in relation to modern day maps. So it's no surprise really, as we're stood here talking about the way in which the A379 has needed to react to that, and the way in which we as communities, businesses and local areas had to change and adapt to it. So thinking back to 2001, there was a prolonged period over which the road was actually closed, and a lot of pressure, and justifiable pressure, from local communities to challenge why it took so long to pull together and develop a response to that. So Slapton Line Partnership was really born out of that particular experience and the need to work collaboratively together. I think as Sarah has already outlined, the partnership has been an integral part of being able to respond in a prompt manner, bringing the various parties together, statutory agencies, community representatives, local authorities, and all the various partners that need really to make this sort of thing happen and work promptly. So it's great that the road is back open again, and in some respects our life can return to normal. But at the same time, it's a very challenging environment within which we live here. On a day like today, with almost pan-flat seas and a slight breeze, it feels hard to remember what the snows and the storm ever brought us in March, but that's what we need to hold in our minds when we look ahead to the future. And the partnership has been busy at work, drawing on a whole breadth of work over the years, looking at the evidence and data that scientists and research engineers have provided for us, canvassing the views of local businesses and communities on what's to go out to consultation as a partnership with you all to look at a beach management plan for the future. Looking at a variety of options, many of you might have come to some of the consultation events that were involved in that. So it's very timely to return back to that piece of work, to look at the adaptation plan for the area, and to just think ahead and be mindful that we know that the road has an indefinite future, and perhaps Storm Emma was just that little reminder that indefinite might mean not that too far off, distance away. So today is about celebrating the